Polar Exhibition. Welcome to the Geophysical Observatory in Świder, which was set up in 1910, becoming the first magnetic observatory on Polish lands. Nowadays, the Geophysical Observatory of the Institute of Geophysics, Polish Academy of Sciences, deals mainly with atmospheric electricity and conducts comprehensive meteorological measurements and observations of gaseous, aerosol, and radioactive air pollutants. What you're looking at is a building from 1910, known as the Second Magnetic Pavilion. Conducted inside it were absolute measurements of the Earth's magnetic field. The structure of the building does not include any iron elements to minimize interference. Since 2012, the pavilion has held a polar exhibition devoted to the Polish polar station Honsund in Spitsbergen and the research conducted there. Let's start from a panorama of the Honsund Fjord displayed on a nearby building. The photograph was taken from the top of Fuglaberget near the station. Many find it hard to believe that the distance between the station and the highest peak in sight, known as Honsund Tind, is 15 kilometers. We're starting the tour of the indoor exhibition from another panoramic photograph taken from Fuglaberget towards the east. Visible in the photo is the terminus of the Hans Glacier, lying about 2 kilometers from the station. Once again, the scale comes as a surprise, especially when we realize that the glacier's terminus rises up to 60 meters above sea level. One of the devices on display is a theodolite. It's used for taking highly precise, exactly measured photographs, which may then be used, for example, to show how a glacier retreats.
Na przykład linię wycofywania się czoła lodowca. To jest
This is the oldest photograph showing the glacier's former extent and the lines, which are based on photographs taken every 5 years at roughly the same time of year, show how it has changed.
Co 5 lat, mniej więcej o tej samej porze roku.
The history of the Polish polar station Honsund in Spitsbergen is presented on a few display boards. They show what the station looks like now and what it looked like before. The first photo shows the original building from 1957, and then the same building after alterations made in 1978 and 1980. The next board shows the station as it is now, after a modernization completed in the years 2003-2005. This part of the exhibition shows the equipment used by the wintering teams in the old days, like ski touring skis and crampons. The exhibition includes also older expedition equipment, such as down outfits including jackets and trousers, which used to serve as a survival equipment in emergency situations, such as a fire at the station.
Elementy ratunkowe do przeżycia.
But also as regular fieldwork gear for those, for example, who carried out long-term stationary observations. And also in critical situations to protect against hypothermia, a person hurt while outdoors. The next part of the exhibition deals with oceanographic research. Oceanographic research involves a few different activities. One is collecting sediment samples from the bottom of a fjord. It is done with the use of a sampler like this one, carried to the bottom by gravity. The obtained samples of sediments from the fjord's bottom are then thoroughly analyzed. What's also carried out are studies of water parameters such as temperature, chemical properties, and suspended particles. Samples are collected with the use of a Nansen bottle, a device which is lowered from a ship on a steel cable until it's at a specific depth.
Na stalowej linie ze statku na odpowiednią głębokość, kiedy osiąga tą głębokość, wysyła się posłanka.
Once it's where it's supposed to be, a messenger weight is sent down, the bottle is tripped over, the valve close and the sample can be pulled up to the surface.
Próba może być wyjęta na powierzchni. Badania dna prowadzi się również metodami.
The seafloor is also studied using geophysical methods and boomer type devices.
To jest źródło fali dźwiękowej.
A boomer emits an acoustic wave which is sent straight down, reflects off the seafloor and is then recorded by hydrophones pulled underwater along with the boomer.
ciągnięte w wodzie obok źródła i w efekcie...
What we get as a result are images of the bottom of the fjord below the ship.
Jak wygląda dno fjordu w tym miejscu, nad którym przepłynął statek.
That's the end of our virtual tour of the exhibition. Do come and see it in person during one of the educational events organized at the observatory.
Material was prepared for the project EDU ARCTIC 2, from polar research to scientific passion, innovative nature education in Poland and Norway, which receives a grant of €240,000 received from Iceland, Liechtenstein and Norway under EEA funds.